of their our courses. And we thank God for all those pastors who put those things on YouTube so that we can know these things. Because if we didn't see these videos, all those pastors exposing them on YouTube, we wouldn't know about this. It's an alarming thing for a pastor to be cursing their people because they didn't bring offering, they didn't bring seed, they didn't bring tithes. It's alarming. That is not the gospel of Jesus Christ. That is not the gospel that Jesus left with the disciples. That is not the way Jesus operated. That was not the way his disciples and Paul and co. operated, the early churches. So these things are alarming. When people send me these videos, when I see these videos, I see I'm shocked. When I hear people giving testimony of all these things, I'm shocked. So be not afraid. And thank God for those who are exposing them, exposing their bad work. And this pandemic exposed so many churches and exposed so many false pastors who have no love of God. All they do is use men as merchandise of money. So I say to you, be not afraid of those that curse. If God did not curse you, no man can curse you. To mention also, those that are engaged and love to do witchcraft. Divinations, voodoo, juju, santeria, obia, talisman, enchantment, and evil shrines of demons and Satan against other people and against their destinies. And witchcraft is often used to enhance curses also. Do not be afraid of those people. Those things will only go back upon their heads and on their children's heads. All those enchantment, divination, voodoo, juju, all those things will go back upon their head and their children's head. And these are the things that they are wasting their time and wasting their money. And the Lord God hates those things. The Lord God hates divination. He hates enchantment. He hates voodoo, witchcraft. God hates that. And he rejects those people that does that. And they are abominations unto God, those who practice all those things. Because the main purpose of witchcraft is to destroy people's destiny. And it's always used also to enhance curses upon people. So I say to you tonight, and that's why generation curses go upon their children until it's broken. So do not be afraid of those people. If God be with you, nobody can be against you. As Christians, depart from curses and witchcraft, as I said. If you're a Christian who are involved in curses and witchcraft, I say to you tonight to repent before God and ask God for forgiveness and depart from those things. No man mentioned the name of Jesus Christ can be doing witchcraft to destroy people's destiny. That is not Christian-like. So I say to you tonight, repent and ask God for forgiveness and turn away from witchcraft, divination, voodoo, juju. It will only destroy you and bring generation curse upon your children. If you don't stop those things, that's what happens. As children of God, I want you also to be aware and avoid those things that can bring curses onto Christians. Even because one thing people don't understand about God, you see, God is an holy God. God is a righteous judge. I can't say I'm a child of God now. I go out and start insulting people and causing trouble and bringing hardship into people's life. I will pay for it. God judges both the righteous and the sinners. Likewise, he judges the dead and the living. So God is a righteous God. He always weighs situation. Just because we say we are Christians or we are children of God does not mean we go about doing evil to people. It doesn't matter if we do evil to people in the churches or out of churches to the sinner. God will judge. God is a righteous judge. And he always weighs matter. Nothing is hidden before God. So I'm saying to you tonight, as children of God, be aware and avoid those things that can bring curses upon your own lives also. Number one, if you make a vow before God and you refuse to honor that vow that you make before God, that can bring a curse upon you. And that curse even comes directly from God. Because God says only a fool will make a vow and will not pay it. So it's very important for you to be aware as Christians. Don't go before God and be making promises and tell God, I'm going to do this if you do this. I'm going to do that if you do that. Because if God do this and you don't do that, And you fail to do that, it will bring a curse upon you. So that's why I'm letting you to be aware tonight. Do not make a vow before God. It is better to just keep your mouth shut and not make a vow before God than to make a vow before God and not fulfill it. It can bring a curse upon you. So I want you to be aware of that. And do not allow people to lure you into making a vow. When you go to churches, you see the pastors are saying, oh, speak after what I say, repeat after me. Do not repeat after any person. Hear what they are saying first before you start repeating. Some people can commit you, make you to be committed and sin against God and put you into vow, indirectly putting you to vow before God that you yourself did not plan to do. And that can also bring you a curse because you repeated after them. They will tell you, oh, repeat after me. Oh, you promise you do this, you do that for, oh, you promise and you'll be, you, and then they get you indirectly. So you can directly make a vow and indirectly people might push you. So when you see those pastors, I say, oh, stand up now, repeat after me. Do not repeat. I don't repeat after anybody because I don't know what they are trying to make me to commit to. I listen. When they first say, if it's not something that will put me in vow or put me in trouble with God, then I can say it. It's not like say, oh, okay, let's pray our Father which art in heaven. Oh, everybody knows that. Or the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. That's different. Or they're talking about may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. That's a different thing. But when they are trying to say, oh, repeat after me, be make sure before you open your mouth, repeat me after people, do not make them to make you to make a commitment before God so that you don't break it and then become a curse upon you. So be careful about that. So as children of God, those things can bring a curse upon children of God to make a vow before God and not fulfill it. Number two, if you enter into an oath in the name of God for a business or for other reasons with another person, a business partner, you must honor that you have said. That will also bring a curse upon you because you use the name of God to witness and you fail to do that to honor to the your business partner or whatever it is, the situation. Remember when David and Jonathan, they took an oath, something like that. That David said, we'll protect Jonathan, we'll protect David, they will protect each other. David honored it. His son, Mephibosheth, something like that. One of Mephibosheth, something like that. The son of Jonathan, who was lame. David took care of the boy. The boy ate at the table of David all his life. He honored the oath. So please be careful. Don't make an oath with anybody. It's always better not to promise what you cannot deliver or to wait when you can deliver something, you just deliver it. But don't enter into oath with people and with the name of God. It can bring you a curse. Number three, if you defraud innocent people, their monies and their properties, and they curse you, they cry before God, that will bring you a curse. It doesn't matter if you're a Christian. You defraud them of their money. You defraud them of their property. They go before God and cry against you. That can bring you a curse. Number four. If a person or persons work for you, they labor for you. You employ them on the job. And you refuse to pay them their wages for their labors. Curse will definitely come upon you. Because the Lord said it in the Bible that the laborers, they have to be paid for their wages because their life depends on it. And what God is saying, when the Bible says their life depends on it, it means that that's how they pay their bills. They buy food. It doesn't matter if they are single man, single woman, married, not married, they have children, no children. Their livelihood depends on that job. So if they work for you, you must pay them. If people work for you, you refuse to pay them their salary, they cry before God, a curse can come upon you as a Christian. And that's why that a pastor was saying that some Christians, some pastors, they like to use people, put them to work hours and hours and hours and say they are doing the work of Jesus. Abusing people. So many pastors, I watched their video on YouTube, and even one of our pastor friends was the first one who told me about 10 years ago. He said, that time I was a health coordinator. I remember there's a lady who was working with me, one of my social worker. I have a nurse, I have social worker, I have different people, health educator. At that time, when I was doing that job, I was like health director there. So that woman, every time she's going, working in church hours and hours. So the pastor told ask her, do they pay you? She said, no. So a lot of people used to, they abuse Christians. I abuse them. They use them to do so much work. Even some use their wife. I hear that in Africa, even some pastors use church members as drivers. They drive their wife, all these things. That's not Christianity. No man should abuse you. God himself, if God is not abusing you, no one should abuse you. That's why Apostle Paul said, after Jesus set you free from the hand of Satan, don't let a man put you in another bondage. Don't let no Christian put you under any bondage. You can help in here, help in there, but hours and hours that are not paid for. So when people work for you, pay them their salary. If you don't pay them, it can bring a curse upon you. If you are doing evil and wickedness to other people, and you make their life miserable, and they cry before God against you, or they curse you, it can come because of your evil and wickedness. If you go around breaking the laws and commandments of God, the children of Israel can explain that to you, what they witnessed on their way from Egypt. And even when they brought them to the promised land in the Old Testament, every time they break the laws of God, the rules, what happens to them? Until they repent again, that is removed. So I just want you to be aware of that as Christians, that you cannot be a Christian and you think you can be walking and be doing evil to people and everything will be fine with you. It doesn't work like that with God. God is a righteous judge. He looks at things righteously. He weighs things. He's a super wise God. This God is a wise God. He knows the beginning to the end. So being a Christian does not mean we'll be abusing people, we'll be making people, turn people to slave for us. No, no. So if you bear false witness, even God warned us about bearing false witness. Do not bear false witness against your neighbor, especially with the name of God. And that false witnesses cause a lot of problem, tragedy, and problem for that person, or even destroy that person. A curse will come upon you. So do not bear false witness against people. You see, these are the things that can bring a curse upon a Christian. And if you rob the poor, the needy, you rob the widows, you rob the orphans, you rob the sick from the little that they have, that can bring a curse upon you. So I want you to be aware as Christians, we have to be aware of these things and not partake in these things. As much as God will protect us from curses that people try to curse us, but we cannot be engaged in these things because it can bring curse upon people. Don't vow what you cannot pay to God. If you vow before God, you must respect it. If you dishonor your father and your mother, it can bring a curse. And that curse is there in the Bible. It can shorten your life, the days of your life on planet Earth. A lot of people have died at younger ages who disrespected their fathers and mother, dishonored their fathers and mother. They never went back to repent. So if you dishonor your father and your mother, that can bring a curse onto a person. It's there in the Exodus chapter 20. It can shorten people's days of life on planet Earth. So be aware of that. Finally, the Bible also said, curse are those who put their trust in men. When you put your trust in men, you are a curse before God and not in God. See, the Bible said, curse are those that put their trust in men and not in God. Example, those whose gods are pastors today. There are some Christians that they are pastors, they are priests, they are bishops, have become their gods. You cannot put your trust in no man. You cannot serve any other man beside God Almighty himself. Beware of that. Who put their trust in governments? Who put their trust in their powers? Who put their trust in people more than God the Creator? The Bible says, cursed are those people. So be aware of those. Some people are walking under a curse without even knowing it. So my brothers and sisters, what is a curse? A curse is an utterance intended to invoke a supernatural power to inflict harm or punishment upon someone. You see, so when people wake up early morning to go curse other people, or at night or whatever time they are doing it, their main purpose is to harm and punish somebody. I'm not talking of those people that you see on the street, in the train station, on the train, who just curse people, MFF, MFF. When they are angry, they just say MFF, MFF. Those people, they do those curses from anger. It's not, they are not very serious. What they are doing is wrong. You should not be cursing people. That's number one. But those people, they just say that from anger. Even sometimes when they realize that, they are sorry. Who would just, hey, MF, MFF, MFF. So those are different categories. But there are people who wake up early to curse people, or wake up at night to curse people, or who go to enchantment, go to voodoo men, juju men, take people's name and pictures to go curse, that curse me this person. And prophets that curse. These are serious things. So, as I say, curse is an utterance intended to invoke a supernatural power to inflict harm or punishment upon someone. It's an offensive word. When I use, for example, that when those people get upset, they use MFF, you know, it's an offensive. Offensive word to express anger. So that's that category. They don't go to witchcraft people. They don't wake up early morning to curse people or pray that something evil happened to people. They are just angry, they say something, and that's the end. Curse is bad because curse is opposite of blessing. Witchcraft, divination, enchantment, juju, voodoo, and santeria are also used by many to invoke and prepare curses. You see, they use it to invoke and prepare curses. That's why you see sometimes, if you watch those African movies, you see they have something in there, they hold something like a horn and speaking to it before they curse people. These are all enchantments to invoke evil, to make sure to say, oh, maybe it will be powerful, that curse can happen. So that's why they do that. We've seen some Christians who even testify using fasting to curse people. They say they are fasting so that they can curse people. I don't know where that's supposed to be. A Christian, if you're a true Christian, a child of God, you cannot fast, be fasting and using that fast to curse people. To use fasting to enhance cursing. We've had so many testimonies. They've said even testimony from different cases. They are using fasting to curse people. They curse people while they are fasting. Because they think while they are fasting, they curse people will be stronger. To strengthen and prepare their curses. As children of God, please do not partake in this. And if you've done this, I pray to God that you will repent before God and God may forgive you. Fastings are not to curse people. It's there in the book of Isaiah. God taught us. One day when I talk about fasting, I will discuss that. It's not for tonight. There's a way why God told us to fast. There's a reason for fasting. Fasting is not to use it to curse people. When we fast, it's to set people who are in bondage so that their yoke be broken. It's to fast so that we can help the poor and all this. So there's a list of things why we fast. We want deliverance. We want answer from God. We want to, so that's why fasting. Fasting is not used to propel a cause. So if you're a Christian who have been involved in this, I ask you tonight to go before God and repent and ask him for forgiveness. And those who are not doing that, please do not do that. Do not do that. What are the consequences or signs of a man or a woman under a curse? When somebody is under a curse, there is hindrance in their life. There's retardation in their life and detriment. There's lack of progress in their life. There's lack of achievement in their life. There's lack of accomplishment in their life. There's a complete failure in their life. There's misfortune, bad luck, impossibility. Curses leads to disabler. A curse is a disabler. What is blessing? A blessing is an enabler. Curse is a disabler. Enabler means ability to do things. Why disabler is an ability, not be able to do things. So as blessings is a enabler, curse is a disabler. Nothing works in their life. Nothing is working. It's not working. You see, even when we came to Christ, The Lord said, I break shackles, I break chains, I break prison gates over your life. I break generation curse over your life. That's what God does. Those curses, because we, from walking against the ordinance of God and also sinful lifestyle, plus what people have done to us, when we come to Christ, God breaks everything. It doesn't matter the way that curse comes. He breaks it. You know? But the good news I have tonight, that anybody who is under curse, it could be generational curse, any kind of curse, it could be caused by their sin, by their disobedience to God, or by all any act that I've listed above. The good news is that there is an antidote to curse. It's like somebody have allergy. Maybe they don't eat peanuts. They eat peanuts, they start having swollen. We give them EpiPen. When they still gone to the stage that they cannot breathe, there's something called EpiPen, epinephrine. We give them a shot, 1/1,000 ratio, 0.3 ml. We give them shots in their muscular area. It could be in the deltoid, it could be in their thigh. EpiPen. So it's an antidote to allergic, serious, severe allergic reaction that can cause glottic edema. So why minor thing, when people say they have itches, you give Benadryl or prednisone, but the serious one. So the antidote, or when people talk about snake bite, they have antidote for that. So the antidote is a good news for a cause. And the antidote and medication to treat it and to destroy and cure a cause or causes, it is our Lord Jesus Christ. That's the answer to that. Our Lord Jesus Christ is the antidote. It can destroy curses. It breaks shackles with chain. Because Jesus, Lord Jesus Christ, has the power to break curses, to set the man, woman free from those curses and bring blessings upon their lives. So Lord Jesus, it doesn't matter what it is, it will break shackles, chains, prison gates. Hallelujah. So now, my brothers and sisters, we will go into the word of God quickly. Let's go to the book of Genesis, chapter 12, verse 3. And I say unto you, be not afraid of those that curse. If God be with you, no one can be against you. Hold your peace and God will fight your fight for you. No man can curse those that God has not cursed. God, you cannot curse those that God has blessed. If God himself has not cursed you, no one can curse you. Do not be afraid of intimidation. Whether it comes from prophets, pastors, your enemies, the jealous people, your haters, it does not matter. No man can curse those that God has blessed. If God himself have not cursed you, no man can curse you. Be not afraid of those people. Genesis chapter 12. Hallelujah. Genesis chapter 12, verse 3. And I will bless them that bless thee, and curse him that curseth thee. And in thee shall all families of the earth be blessed. You hear what Lord God was telling Abraham? He said, I will bless them that bless thee, and curse him that curseth thee. And in thee all families of the earth will be blessed. My friend, if God has blessed you, God have a plan for you. I'm giving you a prophetic ministration, prophetic messages, dreams, prophetic dreams and prophetic visions of where he's taking you. No man can stop it. No man can stop it. No woman can stop it. God will bring his word to pass. Walk with God, fear God, love him. Do whatever he's asking you to do, and you will be okay. If we go to the book of Numbers 22, Numbers chapter 22, sorry, my friends, my throat is a little bit dry. And the children of Israel set forth and pitched in the plains of Moab, on this side Jordan, by Jericho. And Balak, the son of Zippor, saw all that Israel had done to the Amorites and Moab, and was so afraid of the people because they were many. And Moab was distressed because of the children of Israel. And Moab said unto elders of Midian, now shall this company lick up all that are round about us, as the ox licketh up the grass of the field. And Balak, that's the prophet, no, that's the king. And Balak, the son of Zippor, was king of the Moabites at that time. He sent messengers, therefore, unto Balaam, the prophet, the cousin that was hired to curse the children of Israel, to Balaam, the son of Beor, to Petor, which is by the river of the land of the children of his people, to call him, saying, behold, there is a people come out from Egypt. Behold, they cover the face of the earth, and they abide over against me. You know? And say, come now, therefore, I pray thee, curse me these people. You hear? You say, come now, therefore, I pray thee, curse me these people, for they are too mighty for me. Peradventure I shall prevail, that we may smite them, and that I may drive them out of the land. For I wot that he whom thou blessest is blessed, and he whom thou cursest is cursed. Because that's what he believed. When I tell people, a lot of people come, when they say, thank you, you pray for me, you are the one who, I say, no, sister, I pray for you. No, it's God that answers prayer. God can use us to do things, but we are not the one who do it. That's why I told people every time when God do something, they allow miracle, answer prayer or something, that we ask them and they give testimony. I say, no, no, we don't do it. It's God himself who do it. I might pray for you, but it's God that answer prayer. God can choose to answer any prayer, and he can choose not to answer prayer. God can choose to do a miracle, and I can choose not to. So glory goes to God. But you see, this guy that is not a man that knows God, this king, is telling the prophet, he say, I know if you bless, if you bless, you'll be blessed. If you bless somebody, the person will be blessed. If you curse the person, no. No, no. Blessings comes from God. Everything comes from God. Answer prayer, miracles, wonder. Everything comes from God. Then you see some pastors today say, oh, I heal this person. I can heal you. Send me 5,000. I will heal you. I'll do miracle for you. Except if it's fake. But if it's the real miracle that is done, it's from God. Everything that we do is from God. The power is God. The anointing is God. The kingdom and the glory is of God, not of us. But you see, this king is telling him, he's telling the prophet, I want that he whom thou blessed is blessed, he whom thou cursed is cursed. You see, because he have no idea. So moving on, and the elders of Moab and the elders of Midian departed with the rewards of divination. You see what I say? Divination. That they use this also for curse, to enhance curses. So when I tell you things, it's according to the word of God. And that's why I always quickly go back to the scripture, so you know it's not my word. You see? And reward of divination in their hand. And they came unto Balaam, that's the prophet, and spake unto him the words of Balak of the king. And he said unto them, Lord, ye are this night, and I will bring you word again, as the Lord shall speak unto me, and the princes of Moab abode with Balaam, the prophet. And God came unto Balaam and said, what men are these with thee? You see, I told you before, God, when God asks questions, it's not because God doesn't know. God wants to see whether you tell him the truth or you tell him the lie. When God was asking Cain, where's your brother? You see, God knows already. The blood of Abel has been received already in heaven. He's crying against his brother. God told him, say, the earth has received the blood of your... So when God was asking Adam and Eve, where are you? God knows about. So when God asks questions, it's not because he doesn't know. He wants to see what answer you will give. So now God is asking the Balaam, who is the prophet. He said, what men are this with thee? And Balaam said unto God, Balak the son of Zippor, king of Moab, has sent unto me, saying, behold, there's a people come out of Egypt, which covereth the face of the earth. Come now, curse me them. Peradventure I shall be able to overcome them and drive them out. And drive them out. And verse 12, and God said unto Balaam, the prophet. You see, so don't be amazed when you hear those pastors cursing people. They've been doing that in the Bible also. You see, Balaam, the prophet, that's what he was hired to do also. You see? So all this thing that is happening today, don't be surprised. It will even get worse. If you look, that's why we tell people to eat the word of God. Spend time with in the word of God. Old Testament, New Testament, so that you can know the character of God. And you can know God for yourself, that no man can stand and deceive you with the word of God. And if you have the Holy Spirit will decode it unto you. So, and God said unto Balaam, thou shalt not go with them. Thou shalt not curse the people, for they are blessed. You see what Almighty God said, the God of heaven. He said, thou shalt not curse the people, for they are blessed. And that's why I told you tonight, if God has blessed you, no man can curse you. No prophet, no pastors can curse you. As long as you are on your right side. I gave you an example where curses can come upon you. If you are doing evil and wickedness on people and they cry against you or curse you, yes, because you are. But if you're on your right path, no man can curse you. So now if we go to the verse 17. For I will promote thee unto very great honor, and I will do whatever thou sayest unto me. Come therefore, I pray thee, curse me these people. Even want to bribe him, give him gifts, a lot of gifts so that I can curse the people. But God told him, he said, thou shalt not curse the people, for they are blessed. So my brothers and sisters, if we go to verse 23, chapter 23, from verse 7 to 8. And he took up his parable and said, Balak, the king of Moab, have brought me from Aram, out of the mountains of the east, saying, come, curse Jacob, and come, defy Israel. How shall I curse whom God hath not cursed? You see? You see what the prophet is saying? I hope these pastors understand that also. He said, how can I curse whom God hath not cursed? Or how shall I defy whom the Lord hath not defied? No one can curse you if God has not cursed you. You see what he said? The prophet said, so be not afraid of those who like to curse. Now if we go to Romans chapter 12, verse 14. Romans 12, 14. Hallelujah. Romans chapter 12, verse 14. 14. 12, 14. Okay, the Bible says, bless them which persecute you. Bless and curse not. You see, God is telling us, even when people persecute you, don't worry. Leave it unto God. God will fight for you. He said, bless and curse not. You know, so sometimes even people do us something, or children, you see, your children sometimes, especially kids, they so do something to parents that you want to, you're so angry, you hold on. It happens to every family. It happens to every, you know, it happens. So even when we are growing up, that you offend your parents, you know, you hold on, you know. So, but in general, even those who do evil for you, pray for them. That's what I do. And I see how God give me victory, even on job places. God turn over all this evil and turn it into blessings for me, even recently. So go before God. So try as much as possible through the power of the Holy Spirit. Curse not. Don't curse people. Don't follow those pastors who curse people and join them and be cursing people. Do not do that. Leave them alone. They will pay sooner or later. So don't join people to do that. Curse not. Your enemy, pray for them. When I first came to Christ, when God told me, asked me to forgive a lot of people who have done wrong to me, it was so difficult. But through the power of the Holy Spirit, boom, 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 saw my call. They were shocked. I started talking, you know. So don't worry. What is important for us is to be in the hand of God. That's the beautiful thing. For us to have the courage and protection of God, coverage and protection of God. And no man can move you. And at the end of the day, they will pay. So do not worry. Do not be afraid. Just do what is right before God. Do what is right before people. And stay out of trouble. And you are okay. It's true, sometimes, even when you stay out of trouble, trouble is looking for people. Remember when the devil, God asked Satan, the same thing how God asked question, where are you coming from? Where have you been? Satan said, I've been roaming all over the world. He's a roaring lion looking for trouble. You might not cause trouble, but sometimes trouble may come to look for you. It happens always, even when you don't want trouble. So, but stay and trust God, and you'll be okay. If we go to the book of Nehemiah, chapter 13, the book of Nehemiah, chapter 13, verse 1 to 3. Nehemiah chapter 13, verse 1 to 3. Let me read quick. Okay. On that day, they read in the book of Moses in the audience of the people, and therein was found written that the Ammonite and the Moabite should not come into the congregation of God forever, because they met not the children of Israel with bread and with water, but hire Balaam. You see, when I was in that reading the Numbers, right, that prophet Balaam, but hire Balaam, when the children of Israel left Egypt, walking in the wilderness on their way to the promised land, so they did not meet them with water and bread. They hire Balaam, the prophet, to curse them. So because they met not the children of Israel with bread and with water, but hire Balaam, the prophet, against them, that he should curse them. Howbeit, our God turned the curse into a blessing. You see? So even when people curse you, God will turn that curse into a blessing. I repeat myself, even when people curse you, whether you know it or not, God will take that curse and turn it into a blessing. You hear? That's so sweet about our God. He said, howbeit, and having the curse of Balaam, he said, howbeit, they hired Balaam against them, that he should curse them. Howbeit, our God turned the curse into a blessing. That's what God does. He turns the curse into a blessing. Even when people try to do you evil, recently it happened to me. The evil that they wanted to do unto me, God turned it into a blessing, promotion, and more money. That's what God does. That's why I love God. That's why I tell people, hold on to God. You're running after politicians. Some people trust government so much. They trust all this government of this world so much. Running after them. Running after politicians. Running after politicians. Running after pastors. Worshipping pastors. Pastors have become their gods. And God Almighty, the creator of the universe, the most powerful God, they turn their back. And you wonder where your life is messed up, where their life are messed up. The one that has life. The one that has life. It's like your fridge. Your fridge is making ice, it's cold. When you unplug it, what happened? Everything starts melting. So you have to be plugged to Jesus. The life is in Jesus. When you plug to Jesus, you plug to Jesus, you have life. And that's why I tell people, they have not read their Bible. They have not prayed to God. Running after pastor. Running after pastor. Running after politician. Running after politician. Running after people. Running after cash. Cash. Even when I was in the world, before I met Christ, I was not running after people. The only people I know, my parents and my brothers, they did everything for us. That even when I didn't know Christ, I never run after people or be kissing up to people. We don't do that. I wonder, people say they are Christian and they are doing these things. It baffles me. Hold on to God. Hold on to Jesus. Hold on to Holy Spirit. And fear not those that curse. God will turn those curses into a blessing. That's what God does for his people.